So, October 25th, 2016 marked an important day in Wii collecting history, just as 2017 came out, and thus forth the final Wii game ever made, presumptuously, although we're pretty golly dang confident of this because, the system is almost 11 years old now and wouldn't make too much sense otherwise, despite the fact that Just Dance 2017 was surprisingly enough fairly close to selling 1 million units, and I don't know if there's gonna be any reprints, but my guess is no. So it could very well exceed 1 million. I have no clue why. It surprised me, and also kind of made me laugh in one fell swoop, and I'm not entirely sure how I feel about it even now. But regardless, October 2016, I believe, was also the same month. The first person, Casey the Game Nerd, completed a Wii collection of all 1,265 or so games. I've also heard 1,262, and I don't know what that would include and exclude, but whatever. And shortly afterwards, in the January of 2017, two other people managed to get a complete Wii set, those people being Nintendo Twizzer and Retro Thunder. Both of which I believe have fairly lengthy posts on it, and Nintendo Twizzer in particular made an excellent video on it of the top 40 rarest Wii games, and it may or may not be like very inaccurate, but it's at least better than random tense crappy videos. So there's that. So. I figure this is probably the best time out of any year and decade and lifetime to collect for the Wii because it's just out of relevancy. 2016 was probably the definitive best year because back then games like Shiro and the Wanderer didn't go for too much money. So Wii collecting is on the rise just a tad bit, but it's still pretty dang cheap. You can get 90% of the games for like under $10. Which you can't say the same about the GameCube, the PS. No, what are you doing? PS2? What am I talking about? N64, NES, things of the sort. So, this is gonna be a bit of a time capsule video and also a filler video, as well as an apology for me not uploading for like over 2 months. So, yeah, sorry about that. I made some like random filler videos on VidMe, or at least like one, but whatever, this is aside from the point. I'm making videos, promise. I promise. You're gonna find them eventually, maybe. So, yeah, back to what I was saying. This is gonna be more like a time capsule than anything else for myself to just ogle at and how terrible my Wii collecting demonstration was back then. I can't talk right now. Because I'm gonna start collecting for the Wii. However successful it may or may not end up being, that's up to debate. So I'm basically done with NES. I really don't care about collecting it anymore because it's way too expensive. And I'm also planning on selling a good chunk of the games. I think this is like 18 or 19 or so, and there's also a couple boxed ones like right here. So that's gonna help fund Wii collecting and Genesis collecting and maybe Saturn collecting somewhere down the line. That's the plan for now, and I said I would make a collecting video on the N64 in July. I'm probably still gonna do that, but this is gonna be just a random thing to post onto the channel. I don't know why, I just have a lot of fun rambling in these videos, just talking about random games that nobody cares about. So we're gonna do that right now. So let's get to it. Dancing with the Stars is the first one here. I actually haven't played this game ever. Ooh, because it was my sister's. It's by Activision, so that's how you know it's high quality entertainment. So, let's go to the next one. Daddy East Arcade Classics. I actually have a decent amount to say about this game. Daddy East Arcade Classics is allegedly one of the rarest Wii games out there. Nintendo Twizzer alleged to say that it's the 28th rarest. I would not agree with that, but I don't know. It's still definitely uncommon for what it's worth. It's got Arcade Classics by Data East, so there's that. You got Bad Dudes, definitely a classic right there. You got Burger Time and some other games, I'm pretty sure. Data East Arcade Classics goes for like $60 complete. I don't know why. Yeah, you see it everywhere. I found this copy in particular out in the wild. I still have not gotten a single Wii game off of eBay, and I'm hoping to keep that track record for as long as I can. I got this one in particular for $20 at a game store a couple months back, which was a good deal even back then. I think complete copies were going for like 55 or 60 back then. It was only a couple months ago. It was in 2017. So there's a little bit of a story there. The game itself is likely a game about Data East Arcade Classics, which, you know. Okay, so Domino Rally is up next. This game is freaking bizarre. And it would, the graphics in this game are... It tries so desperately to have a style, but it kind of fails poorly. Yeah, look up some of the cutscenes in this game. They legitimately look like, you know, Dreamcast material, if that. They best remind me of, like, Chibi-Robo, except somehow even worse. Which, if you don't know what Chibi-Robo is, it's a GameCube game that released way too late for how good it looked. Good being, you know, a relative term. It looks pretty trash for 2006 standards, let's just say that. Not to, discredit Chibi-Robo for anything, in case you don't know, I actually don't even have it in my collection. But I've heard it's a pretty good game, it's just, I saw a Let's Play of it like 6 freaking years ago. Nintendo LP, Audaciously Awkward, anyone remember that one? I barely do, so I wouldn't blame you if you don't. Domino Rally, then we're gonna get back to this. Domino Rally. It's a weird freaking game. I bought it off of Impulse for like $5, as you can see, a couple days ago, if not like closer to a week ago than not. It's by UFO, and UFO is fairly notorious for having really crappy third-party games for the Wii. It's not terrible, I guess. I wouldn't even go as far as to call it mediocre. It's actually kind of a decent little game. It's just really freaking weird and really freaking ugly. But the one thing that it like it makes it, it freaking makes it is the music. It is something special. It's like Sonic R times a million. It is an experience all in itself. The Dog Island. The Dog Island is a game. I don't know. I really like this game. It probably does suck, but. I really like this game. It's a guilty pleasure, if you will. Although I would hardly say that it is objectively bad. It's just, is the kind of game that you pick up and play for like 20 minutes. You're like, what is this? I'm not gonna finish this game. I've finished this game because I've had it since I was a little child. I do own a vast majority of the games I had as a child. This is one of them that I managed to keep from my youth days all the way up until now. My slightly older youth days, the teenage years, almost 16, somewhere around that general vicinity. The Dog Island, though, this game is amazing. I don't know why I think that, but it's an enjoyable little adventure game, however juvenile and easy it may be. It was also on the PlayStation 2. I believe it got released around the same time on the PlayStation 2, and that version's pretty impressive in itself because, the graphics are darn near on par with the Wii version, which is impressive. You know, much to my chagrin, the PlayStation 2 was, PlayStation 2 was a lot more powerful for its time than the Wii. The PlayStation 2 was capable of 1080p and the Wii was not, so there's that. GoldenEye 007, I got this at a garage sale for like $2 and I haven't played it yet. I remember this one being like a fairly big deal back in 2010 or something. Yeah, that's more reason than not why I got it. Because garage sales, like, Wiis and garage sales are hand in hand. They're a couple for life. Maybe not for life, but at least for like the next 4 or 5 years. They're just, people really like to empty out their Wii collections as garage sales right now. So it's a good opportunity to buy a handful of these games. GoldenEye 007 is one of them. For my personal collection, I'm rambling too much, but I don't really care. Two other people are gonna watch this video anyway, so there's that. I haven't played it yet, because I kind of just don't care about FPSs in general. As new as I gets, like, around the Hexen era, maybe Quake, somewhere around there, everything else just boils together in a mesh of junk. Klonoa's up next. This is another one I got from a garage sale for like $2. I know it says $3 right there, but I'm pretty sure I raggled it down if I remember correctly. This game goes for a decent amount still. It goes for like 30 or so, because it didn't sell very hot. It didn't sell hot at all. And it also inadvertently spiked the prices of the original PlayStation 1 game. That version goes for a ton now. It goes for like well over 100 from what I remember, although I don't really pay attention to PlayStation 1 collecting at all. I actually don't even own a Sony system yet, though I make it a plan of mine to get a PS1 and a PS2 one day. It's not something I'm willing to focus on right now, especially considering how, I don't have any Sega systems really either, so... I think the Sega systems are gonna take predominance over that. And also the Wii, because, you know, I already went over this. What am I talking about? Klonoa on the Wii, the remake. It's alright, I don't freaking know. I might be in the minority for saying this, but it's kinda vanilla. It's definitely not a poorly made game, but it's just, you get bored of it after like 20-30 minutes. It's polished for what it's worth, but it's like the new Super Mario Bros. Games for the Wii U. You've seen that crap before. It may have some ounces of ingenuity, but it's just... it's bland by the standards of other games which have come before. It's LEGO Star Wars and the Complete Saga is a LEGO game for the Wii. The 6th, 7th, and 8th generations are pretty reputable for having decently good LEGO tie-in games. I don't know why, just the LEGO license in general for media is quite good. There's like hardly any actual bad LEGO games, which is very surprising. I don't really have much else to say. It's just LEGO Star Wars and the Complete Saga. What do you want me to say? It's the LEGO game. It is based on Star Wars, which I've never seen any of the Star Wars movies, so I don't have any nostalgic memories over those little gems. Little gems! My Corner Rimpa Marble Mania, which it took me a good 2 weeks into buying this game to properly pronounce that title. This game is really friggin' hard to find. I don't know why. I did a review of it not too long ago. Not too long ago, of course, being, you know, late January, but we're gonna forget about that little upload schedule fiasco! It was by the Hudson Bee. It was also a Japanese launch title, from my understanding. And, you know, those two things don't necessarily go hand in hand, but in this particular example, Korimpa is one of my favorite games on the Wii. It's overall a very enjoyable little product. A product of a distant past when motion controls were actually being used to the advantage of a game rather than its hindrance. I got this for $10 at a game store, an undisclosed game store, a couple months back. In this game, I know it doesn't go for a whole lot of money, but it is really stinking hard to find out in the wild, so I'm glad I got it for that cheap. It usually goes for like 25 or so on eBay and sites like that, maybe 20 if you're lucky, or you wait a good while to get a cheaper copy. But regardless, it's alright. It used to be like a titan of Wii collecting before, yeah, back in the early days, early days of Wii collecting. Back when reprints were so abundant and possible that I don't know why anyone would ever try to collect for the Wii in the late 2000s, case in point being a One Piece Unlimited adventure, but you know, those days are behind us now. We've learned from our mistakes. So wait, Mario and Sonic at the 2016 Olympic Games is going for $70 right now. We're gonna forget about that, I guess. Mario and Sonic at the 2008 Olympic Games is a different story altogether, and by that I mean no, it's not, because they recycled the same darn game over and over again for the Mario and Sonic at the Olympic X Year Games. It's kind of a meme now, but I mean, back in 2008, people took it relatively unironically, I guess, sort of. I don't freaking know. It's Mario and Sonic at the Olympic Games. Generally mediocre package altogether. I haven't played 2012 or 2016, nor will I probably ever play 2016 because it's going for $70 on eBay right now. I don't know why. But regardless, I don't freaking know. Mario Kart Wii is up next. This is one of my favorite games ever. Probably my favorite game on the Wii. Probably my favorite Mario Kart game. Although, I don't know. I haven't played 7 or 8 yet. 8 could eat me for all I'm concerned. It looks pretty stinking terrible. But Mario Kart Wii is... It's a nostalgic game of mine. I've had this copy for years and years, and I had to get it cleaned recently because it stopped working.
just all sorts of fun nostalgic stories. But regardless, we're gonna real talk for a second. Mario Kart Wii is one of my favorite games ever, even though I know for a 100% fact that it's a broken heap of trash. It's just, I like the way that this game controls over every other Mario Kart game ever. It's so, so tight. And Mario Kart DS is not far behind it. Mario Kart DS is probably the most generally solid game out of the Mario Kart franchise, at least that I've played, because it doesn't have a crappy battle mode. And Mario Kart Wii was the first to have, you know, that little fiasco go down. At that point, it was just mediocre, but it only went downhill from there. New Super Mario Brothers, is a game. It's a first-party Nintendo game. I remember this game. It's pretty good, I guess. I don't know. I haven't played it in a good while. But regardless, it's got that nice little... nice red shell, because that's not annoying at all. I don't know. It's first-party Nintendo, and this was back when the new Super Mario Bros. Series wasn't dead. So there's also that. I haven't played the DS version in a while either, but I remember that version being significantly better. I don't know. New Super Mario Bros. Wii has the four-player mode, which has very mixed reception overall, to say the very least, but I don't know, I liked it. It was a fun kind of chaotic. Raving Rabbit's Party Collection was my sister's game, and I've never played it. Sheeran the Wanderer, this game goes for a lot of money now. It's probably the most expensive Wii game that I own, because, you know, Dungeon Crawler Anime RPG by Atlus. Those words in the same sentence, they're a recipe for disaster. Sheeran the Wanderer's rather difficult to find. You still find copies of it every now and then. I would put it on like a tier probably above Quadrimpa and Data East Arcade Classics in terms of like commonness. It's definitely not Mario Kart Wii tier, but it's far from, I don't know, Maximum Racing Super Truck Racer tier. Yeah, that's an actual game, by the way. I wasn't saying that in an ironic sense. Sheeran the Wanderer, though, I remember playing this for a couple hours one night. It was pretty enjoyable from my experience. The only reason why I have this, to be honest, is because I found it out in the wild for 15, which is very, very, very cheap for this game. It was turned in, evidently, on New Year's Eve 2016. The only good thing to happen in 2016, no doubt. And I got it the same day I got Karimba. I think I already said that, but whatever. It was just there. I got it. Why not? And complete prices were skyrocketing back then. They pretty much plateaued out at like 65, I think, last time I checked. I don't freaking know. But regardless, Sheeran the Wanderer, decent little game. I would probably prefer getting it on the N64, because if you don't know, Sheeran the Wanderer is like a game series that's much more popular over in the Land of the Rising Sun, and there's an N64 Sheeran the Wanderer, and I want to get it. It was released only in Japan, so it might be a little difficult to track down a copy, but that's why eBay is a thing. The Strike! I don't know why I bought this. Super Mario Galaxy 2! Is the first party Mario game. Mario in the, I don't fucking know. There's Mario in it, there's Yoshi in it, and that's a winning combination right there. 10 out of 10. IGN. I don't freaking know. Super Paper Mario is up next. The Paper Mario fans, if you don't know, are like the most persnickety people on the internet. Some of them love this game, some of them hate this game. Most of them hate this game. Nowhere near as much as Color Splash and Sticker Star, though, because he doesn't have the thousand-year door structure. But Super Paper Mario is like the happy medium for them, I guess. I don't freaking know. I remember it being good. I haven't played it in years, but I don't think I ever got past like chapter 3 or 4. I don't freaking know. This is gonna be a trend, just I don't freaking know. I haven't played most of these games in forever. I just like collecting for the Wii because it's cheap, and there's a lot of really stupid shovelware games for it. This is not stupid, nor is it a shovelware game, nor is it very cheap, so I don't have much to say about it. It doesn't pique my interest. How about that? Wheel of Fortune. This is a crappy shovelware game, but it's not very interesting, but it is cheap. contrary to that price tag, I got this game back when it was new, so, you know, there's that. This is a GameStop price tag, actually. Ooh, spooky. It's for Wheel of Fortune, though. This is a really stupid port of Wheel of Fortune. You see this? These, like, depictions of Pat Sajak and Vanna White, those are actual in-game models, and the lip-syncing is bloody atrocious. So it's kind of like a dumb fun, for what it's worth. And just Wheel of Fortune games in general, I feel like the general consensus is, like, they're stupid fun to play with other people. And, like, even when you're by yourself, it's just, there's something so oddly fun about just blatant shovelware like this. It's Wheel of Fortune. What do you want me to say about it? Child, I own Wheel of Fortune on the... on the freaking Commodore's. No, I don't. Never mind. Wait, do I? Hold on. Yeah, baby. Here's Wheel of Fortune. This is not Commodore 64, but found this at a Goodwill for $4. I don't know why I picked it up. I'm never going to be able to play this in my life, but it's for the IBM PC, not the Commodore 64. This is why I'm not a... You're just going to stay there for a while. This is why I'm not a PC gamer. Wii Fit Plus. Wii Fit Plus. I don't freaking know. I used to have the original Wii Fit, but I sold it at one point. There's like four or five, maybe six... I think somewhere around four or five Wii games that I ended up selling at one point in life. But I'm not going to sell anymore. I'm going to keep... even the Striker, which I still don't know why I ever bought. Wii Sports, though. Wii Sports is, you know, I have a pretty vanilla opinion about this game overall. It's Wii Sports. What do you want me to say about it? It's one of the better launch games, one of the better pack-ins, because, you know, pack-ins were a thing at one point. I think the... Oh, does the Switch have pack-in? I don't think it does. It should have been 1-2 Switch, because that game is terrible for $50. But whatever. Opinion alert. Although I don't think anyone would disagree with me. Wii Sports Resort, same thing, really. It's just, I have a very vanilla opinion about Wii Sports Resort. I own two copies of it, because one of them broke at one point down the line. And this was back in, like, 2010. We were dumb people back then, so instead of trying to clean it, we just bought another copy altogether. So, here we go. Here's Wii Sports Resort and... Wii Sports Resort. And I can't fit them both on the shelf anymore, because I got Domino Rally. So there's that. Zack and Wiki Quest for Barbaros' Treasure is up next. For the longest time, people cited this as, like, the only good third-party game for the Wii. And that's a really stupid thing to say, and I think everyone knew that back in the late O's. But, it is good. There's some truth to that statement. I haven't played it in years... if you can believe it, but it's not because I don't take interest in this game, because I do. It's because... Oh, can we open this with one hand? Boom, baby! Oh, this isn't Zack and Wiki Quest for Barbaros' Treasure, this is Mario Sunshine, and a non-functioning copy on top of that. And by that I mean it does function, but for like a whopping 30 seconds before it crashes. I lost the disc at some point in time, I don't know when. It was probably somewhere around like 2012 or 2013. But from what I remember, Zack and Wikipedia, Quest for Barbaros' Treasure was a pretty good game. In the time that I had with it, I should get a replacement copy at one point in life. But I'm waiting until it's really, really cheap, like $5 or something. I'm not paying $10 for a Wii game. Get out of here! Zumba Fitness, join the party. Never played this one. It was my sister's and my mom's, to an extent. That was, Anyways, that was the Wii collection, ladies and gents, boys and girls, children of some ages, hopefully. If you're in the single-digit age group, you shouldn't be on the internet at all. But especially watching my insanely vulgar freaking content. That should scare all of them away. Now I'm 18 plus only. I can show my penis for all you care. But regardless, that was the collection video. I hope you enjoyed, and I will see you hopefully later with the review. The key word in that sentence was hopefully. Goodbye.